one of the people who had the, I think not from anything he did, but what he enabled me to do, and that was Keith Johnson. He's the man who released any inhibitions I might have had.
His work has had an enormous influence, either directly or indirectly, on generations of actors, writers, and directors. Going into a rehearsal room now is a totally different world to the one that it was back in the 1960s.
90% of the time, if I improvise something, I always were either called back, put on hold, or booked the job. I got the role in Spider-Man 2, the first real role I got in a movie, which is a very small role, but I improvised for an hour.
But if there's something risky going on in improvisation, I'm liable to go and watch it. But people are all trying to make it safe. They don't want to fail because they don't know how to fail happily. If you fail happily, the audience love you and want to take you home because you seem so good-natured. But you have to train that.
It was reading Keith's book that really made me into a playwright. And I thought, I suppose as many of us do before that, oh, wouldn't it be great to be a writer, to be a writer? I'd spent many years doing that, but I couldn't figure out a way in. But actually reformulating some of those exercises as exercises for a writer totally unlocked it for me. And from then on in, I have worked and earned my living as a playwright. So I do in many ways owe it to Keith.
Either it was 1971, I was working at the theatre school in Copenhagen. For me it was amazing because suddenly I felt somebody came that would change the whole atmosphere at the theatre school, because the way he was working was completely different than the way things were done before.
That suddenly there was this other form of theatre, which I think was where Keith was in his own mind trying to get to, was something that could break the pattern of the traditionally rehearsed and everything as much as possible pre-decided before you got on stage.
It was the ability to create an environment in the theater that was about the relationship between the actors and the audience in this shared space of creating it in the moment.
What happens to a person who's a great teacher to their body of work and how it's looked after?
I think the reason that Keith's work hasn't been more set in stone is its nature is ephemeral. Everything magical and wonderful that happened that Keith produced, you had to be there.
Everybody should know about Keith Johnstone in one way or another, because he's applicable to your life, whether you're an actor, playwright, or a stockbroker, or a scientist. His work is the skill set of being a good human.
Having survived like 200 or 300 of Keith's improvisations, you're in a much better state, psychologically and emotionally, to start saying to be or not to be, that is the question, you know.